Okay, so while skinning this, what I'm going to do is just add a bit of a range of motion in there. So I'm just going to uncheck all my selection mask at the top so I can only select the NURBS curves. And because I know earlier on we cleaned it up, I know that there's no constraints in here. Like, for instance, we can't key the rotate on these. So I know that anything I key, so I've already got a key on that, so I'll just delete that. I know that we're not going to override any incoming connections or any constraints because we've locked and hidden those. So I know that we're not going to have any problems. So I'm just going to select all the curves, and on the first frame just hit S, which keys everything. And I'll move forward to 100. And I'll just start with auto key. So at the bottom right you can see the sort of key, and if you click it and it turns red, that means auto key's on. So as I move these manipulators, it's going to automatically set a key. So you can see that red line in the timeline. So I'm just going to set a few keys moving this character. So here we can see we've got this nice arc going on. We want a nice smooth bend, but you can see in here we're getting a bit of crumpling here, so we might want to improve that. Let's move this arm up. Move this arm down. And I'm only really... I'll probably not key the IK-FK switch. So I can right click on that and just go to break connections, which will delete the keyframe data. Switch it to FK, sorry. So I can just manually do these. And we didn't have these selected at the start because they were hidden. So I'll select those as well and just hit S to key. Move to 100, hit S again to key them. And I'll just rotate these into some sort of position. Go back. So I've got frame 200. And reset this spine. So reset these spine controls. Put a value of 0 in there. Auto key's on, so it's going to automatically key that. So I can sort of, at 200 frames, I can just check out the bends in here. 300. I'll straighten these. I can select all three of these actually and just move them to the far back. So this is an unrealistic pose, but again it's a cartoon character, so he might actually put his arm in this pose at some point. Or even just for a bit of in between he might have a broken pose, you know, where these arms bend back slightly, so we want to make sure that it deforms correctly as well. And again, we're not really skinning on the right hand side, I'm just doing it on the left and mirroring it over, so we don't really need to add a whole lot of animation on here, but we could add it anyway. So we can see it when we mirror the weights over. So up here, from 200, I'm just going to get these free. Well, not free, but these sets of curves. Set a key on 200, set a key on 300. Just move them out. See how that's going to work. So you can see here, straight away, that's just getting mashed. So I know that that's an area that needs improving. Same with the eye. The eye is still following this lower antenna bit, so I don't like that. Need to fix that. It's looking quite good. So with that new ribbon spine, it's working quite well. And back here, I'm just going to set a few keys. So I'm going to set a key on 200, set a key on 300, and switch the follow chest off. So now from 300, 400. Select these three. And we're not going to affect the upper body. So set key on 300 and 400. So I'm just pressing S several times. And then with these again, I'm going to do a pause at 400. Oops, and another pause at 500. So the first pause is these just translated out, and then we've also got to remember that we might need to rotate these back. So I'm just doing the two pauses, so I can look when it's been moved and look when it's been rotated as well. Key that, and then at 600 add another key where I can twist that. So you can see here some major problems happening there, but now we can start to skin these. So use this weird range of motion. It's probably a more weird range of motion than usual because some of the squashing, stretching, weird things this character's going to do with his limbs. But we can see now we can go ahead and use this to start editing the skin.